So students, our today's topic is energy. So what is energy actually? Energy, it is the ability to do work. Okay, if we want to do any kind of work, like if I am writing over here and you are studying over there, you are standing or you are sitting, whatever you are doing, for every kind of work we need something. We should have that ability to do that thing, and that ability is actually known as energy. For doing any sort of work we need energy, and that's why energy has so many forms. Okay, there are many forms of energy, so we will read about the different forms of energy now. So I hope it is clear what is energy. For doing any sort of work you need the ability to do that work, and that ability is known as energy. Okay, so in this first form of energy is heat energy, and this heat energy is actually one of the most important form of energy. Okay, it is actually one of the form of energy, and you know that majorly this heat energy is given by the sun. Sun is the ultimate source of energy, ultimate source of heat energy. Okay, so apart from the sun, if we are learning about the sun, then sun is the ultimate source, it is the major source. But along with it, apart from sun, we get heat energy from the different sources also, like when we burn the fuels. Okay, when we burn the fuels in the sense petrol, diesel, wood, etc. Okay, when we will burn the fuels I already told, like petrol, kerosene, diesel, wood, etc. All these are come under the category of fuel. So when we will burn them, we'll get the heat energy. One of the important form of fuel is also LPG, that is liquefied petroleum gas, which we use in our daily life for cooking the food. Now, next form of energy is light energy. Light, you know, when you will turn on the tube light or a bulb, then light comes out. So that is actually the light energy. And this light energy help us to see the things. So some sort of light energy, again sun will come under this category also. Okay, then electric bulb and tube light, candle, etc. Torch, lanterns, all these are the sources of light. Okay, so students, one more thing, if any substance is giving you light, then ultimately they will give you heat also. Okay, so the most of the sources of light are also the sources of heat energy. Okay, now the third form of energy is electrical energy. All the electrical bulbs, okay, and tube lights, television, computers, other electrical appliances, they run on a particular type of energy, and that is known as electrical energy. Okay, they use electrical energy to run. Fine, electricity, now where this electrical energy is there, so this electrical energy is actually present in the electricity. Okay, and that electricity is generated at power stations. Okay, they are generated at power stations and supplied to our homes through wires. This I hope you everybody have observed that in our homes wires are there. One main wire is there, and from that main wire you will get the different lines for the wires in your whole house. Now the fourth type of energy is mechanical energy. Mechanical energy is basically that energy which is possessed by an object. This mechanical energy is actually possessed by any object. Okay, and as this is possessed by any object, then it is basically of two types, on two points. One, when because of its position, and second one is because of its movement. Okay, so this mechanical energy is actually possessed by an object due to its position or its movement. Okay, and that type of energy is mechanical energy. So what two types of mechanical energies are there? One is potential energy and the another one is kinetic energy. First is, or A is, potential energy. Potential means uske andar kitna potential hai koi bhi cheez ko karne ka, theek hai. So this is basically due to the position. Okay, basically due to the position of an energy. Suppose if this board is kept over here, okay, it is its position. So what type of energy is stored in this board? That is the potential energy. So potential energy is basically because of the position of an object. If I have kept this pen over here, okay, then which type of energy will be stored in it? Potential energy. But if I will make this pen to run or to roll, then it is moving, okay, and because during that time when it is moving, at that time there is another form of mechanical energy, that is kinetic energy. Okay, this is due to movement. Okay, now let's take another example of it. Like water is stored in a dam. There is a dam, and in that dam water is stored. So at that time water has their position in the dam. So at that point water has potential energy. Okay, but when that water flows from one place to another, then at that time it has kinetic energy. Or we can say when the water falls from a height, okay, then at that time it has kinetic energy. Okay, so whenever any object is in the motion or is in its movement position, movement, then it possesses kinetic energy, and when they are kept at a position, then that is known as potential energy. Now the last form of energy is sound energy. Fifth is sound energy. This sound energy is that form of energy which comes across, like when you will hear the sound. Right now I am speaking, so sound energy is actually releasing. Okay, here sound energy is there. When there is a like when you will turn on the radio, television, loudspeakers, horns, okay, even the doorbells or the musical instruments, then they are actually the sources of sound energy. Living things also produce sounds, like animals, birds, human beings. They, right now I am producing, you people produce. Okay, so we actually produce the sound energy. So all these are the different forms of energy. Okay, now our next topic is simple machines. Simple machines. So students, when what do you use to fix a nail on a wall? Nail means key, okay? And if you want to fix that nail on a wall, then what you will use? Your hands or a hammer, okay? What you will use to fix the nail in the wall? You will use a hammer instead of your hands. So like hammer, we use many tools in our day-to-day life, okay, to make our life easier, okay, and even we can make our work easier with the help of that tools, and that tools also make do our work faster. So that tools are actually called as machines, okay? So tools are actually the machines. So, you know that machines are of two types. Some machines are simple machines, whereas some machines are complex machines. If we are talking about the hammer, then hammer is a very simple machine. If we are talking about the knife, okay, or if we are talking about the plier, scissors, so these all are very simple machines. But if we are talking about a washing machine or an air conditioner or a refrigerator or computer, so they are also making our work easier and faster. They are also making our life so luxurious, so comfortable, okay? But that machines are very complex, okay? They are also considered as machines, but they are come under the complex machines. And our today's topic is simple machines. So simple machines are actually the tools. Machines are tools. So simple machines are tools that have very simple structure, okay? These machines have very simple structure, means they are not made from so many parts, okay? They have very simple structure and make our work easier and faster. Clear? Whereas complex machines are consist of two or more simple machines, okay? Whatever complex machines we are having, like washing machines, refrigerator or computers or etc. So these complex machines, there are more than two, one or more simple machines are included, okay? And then they come under the complex machines. Okay, and all that simple machines will work together to form a complex machine. For example, now we are talking about the simple machines. A knife and a scissor, they are very simple machine. But along with that, when you will see a sewing machine or a washing machine, then they are come under complex machine. So there are 6 types of simple machines. How many types? 6 types of simple machines, like lever, wheel and axle, inclined plane, screw, wedge and pulley. And what happens, simple machines will either change the direction of force applied or increase the force applied. Either they will change the direction of force or they will increase the force. Increase the force applied. So that they can do. Okay, either they will change the direction of force or they will increase the force applied. They will come under the working process of simple machine. So students, we will learn about the different types of simple machines in the next class. So that's all for today.